Oh, he's coming back around. Oh boy.
Yeah, he's circling.
He's circling.
That is a 12-foot hammerhead shark in Captiva, circling boaters just yards from the beach.
The couple who shot this video, A, is remarkably calm, yeah. And B, they couldn't believe how long the shark hung around and how efficient of a hunter it was. NBC2's Delia D'Ambra live in our studio with the boaters' fishtail for the books.
Yeah, Peter, this is the second large hammerhead shark spotted near Sanibel Island this week. 2 days ago, a man caught one near Blind Pass, and yesterday, another hammerhead approached the boat of a Cape Coral couple drifting in shallow water less than a football-length field from the beach.
That's a good 10-footer there.
John Papes and his wife,
that really made our day yesterday,
are soaking in a moment
shark
they'll never forget. As Papes preps his pontoon boat for another fishing trip, he's not sure it can compare to their Wednesday visit to Captiva.
I seen a fin sitting up swimming around there, and it never went down.
Hammerhead shark swimming by us.
He was not scared of us one bit. Sometimes he'd be within 6 feet of the boat.
Oh, he's coming back around.
Papes and his wife felt safe in their boat, but not so much for people on the beach nearby.
Nobody, I don't think, on the beach recognized him. So that's the scary part. It'll make you think what's out there.
Stumbling across the shark was
a blessing to see it, because you don't see him that often.
But not something
I would run away from it.
Every Captiva visitor,
I would have been a little scared,
wants waiting next to them.
He was definitely on the hunt, and I wouldn't want to be in his way.
Pape says the shark was eating tarpon back and forth along the beach for hours that he and his wife were out there, and it never bothered anyone. It was not aggressive. I reached out to Florida Fish and Wildlife to see if there was any research to explain why we're seeing more hammerheads so close to the island shore, and I'm waiting to hear back. Live in the studio, Delia D'Ambra, NBC2.